In this video, I will show you how to sum the last 10 rows in Excel like this. So let's get started. Here in this Excel sheet, I have day names and their respective order amounts in these columns. Now I want to calculate the sum of the order amounts for the last 3 days, that is Friday to Sunday. To do that, we first need to get the cells containing data for the last 3 days. I will use the Excel offset function to do that. The offset function returns a reference to a range, that is the number of rows or columns from the specified starting cell. This function accepts 5 arguments: a reference of the starting point, the number of rows to offset, the number of columns to offset, optional height in rows, and optional width in columns. For example, let's get the last 3 amounts from the C column using the offset function. To do that, I will select cell C3 as the starting point. Since we want the data starting from the 5th row, that is 4 rows below the starting point C3, I will specify 4 as the row offset argument. We want the data from the same column, so the column offset argument will be 0. The height refers to how many rows we want from the data, so that will be 3 amount cells. I will skip the column width argument because we want the data from only one column. As you can see, the offset function returned the last 3 amount cells as an array. We can also get the same 3 amount cells by specifying the starting point as C9 instead of C1, and then specifying -2 as row offset instead of 4, like this. To get all the data cells from these two columns, that is cells B7 to C9, I will specify cell B7 as the starting point. Since we want to start from the same cell without any offset, I will specify 0 as the row and column offset arguments. Since we want 3 rows starting from cell B7, I will specify the row height as 3. Finally, since we want the data from 2 columns starting from cell B7, I will specify 2 as the width in columns. As you can see, we now have all the data from day and amount columns, 3 rows in height and 2 columns in width as an array. Since we now know how to get the last 10 rows from the data, summing them up is very easy. Let's type an equal sign in the target cell to start the formula. Let's first get the last 3 amount cells using the offset function. This time, I will specify C7 as the first starting point argument, 0 as the row and column offsets, and then specify 3 as the row height argument. As you can see, this offset function will return the last 3 amount cells. Since we want to sum these array elements, I will simply pass this offset function as an argument of the sum function, like this. Hit the enter key to complete the formula. As you can see, we now have the sum of the last 3 rows. Instead of hard coding the n value, we can also refer to a cell containing the n value. For example, in this Excel sheet, I have the n value defined in cell E3. I am going to specify the cell C3 as the starting point. To calculate the offset dynamically, I will first get the count of rows in the C column using the count function, and then subtract the number of last rows we want from the data, like this. I will specify 0 as the column offset and then select the E3 cell as the number of rows argument. Here, the count of cell value will be 7, and when we subtract the number of rows, that is 3, from 7, we will get 4 as the row offset from the starting point C3. Hit the enter key to complete the formula. As you can see, we now have the sum of the last 10 rows dynamically calculated based on the cell value. In this way, we can change the number of rows without changing the formula to get the updated sum dynamically. For example, Changing the number of rows from 3 to 4 will give us the sum of the last 4 rows automatically. Watch these videos for more Excel tips, tricks and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.